may have heard of black holes, but have you heard of white holes? White holes are the unicorns, the fairies, the elves of the galactic landscape. Areas of piercing light and erupting matter. Possible universe creators right there. But are they real? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that loves to talk about all things from space, science, history to pop culture and fiction. Why? Because curiosity swells beyond one topic, and questions are a beautiful thing. I'm your host Rebecca Felgate, and today we are talking about the wider universe as we ask, are white holes real? Before we get into the many holes and paradoxes of space, I want to ask you guys whether or not you find space as a concept scary. I feel like fear is sometimes just a response to the unknown. Would you ever go to space? Let me know in the comments section down below. Also, while you're down there leaving me a comment, why don't you guys hit that thumbs up button and share this video with a friend. If you want to connect with the team that went into making this video on social media, there are links to our Instagrams and Twitters in the description box down below. White holes are a theoretical mathematical concept, and a complicated one at that. They are the opposite equation to black holes, which we know exist. While we have observed black holes, their potential counterparts have yet to be proven and remain somewhat fabled. From what we know of the laws of physics, the universe works in balance. So does that mean that even without observing them, we can assume that they exist? If one were to prove the existence of hell, would that be enough to confirm heaven? Okay, that might have been a dubious example, but anyway. Before we understand what white holes are, let's see what exactly black holes do. Black holes are points in space with so much gravity that all matter is sucked in and can't escape, so far as we can see anyway. Light, the fastest observable thing in the universe, isn't fast enough to escape the clutches of a black hole. We can't actually see these black holes, but we can see the areas where light dies around them and no longer escapes. Black holes form when huge stars collapse in on themselves. In order for something to become a black hole, it must be small and dense, so dense that it starts sucking in all other matter around it. We don't know a lot about black holes, but it is predicted that inside the hole, all directions lead to a funnel where particles are torn up and stretched down to a very hot, dense point of singularity. What happens beyond that singularity, though? We just don't know. But one of those theories is a white hole. So, as black holes draw in all matter to a single hot, dense point, white holes are theorized to spew matter outwards, so not really like holes at all, more like bursts. Which brings us to gamma ray bursts. Gamma ray bursts are the most powerful electromagnetic events in our universe, and we do not yet quite know what causes them. These bursts can vary in duration, most are seconds long, but in 2010, NASA's Swift spacecraft observed one that lasted 28 minutes. In 2015, it was announced that the Swift spacecraft has detected its 1,000th gamma ray burst, which sounds like a lot, but actually, they're pretty rare and come from very far off galaxies. When observed, it seems that gamma ray bursts are jets of light. Are these white holes? If so, where did they come from? And what do they mean? We know that black holes vary in size. There are stellar mass black holes, which are much smaller roaming holes, which come from the implosion of suns much, much denser than ours. There are also supermassive black holes, which are millions of times bigger. These are a lot like the one at the center of our galaxy. We've given ours a name, Sagittarius A, and while it is a big black hole, they likely are bigger. The reason I bring this up is, as we know, gamma ray bursts also vary in size and intensity. Could this be in correlation with varying sizes of black holes? So let's circle back to gamma ray bursts and draw a link between another big mystery in our universe. The Big Bang. The Big Bang is a very credible theory on how our universe may have started and formed. Many describe the event as a very hot, dense outward explosion that cooled and expanded to form what we know today. Lending evidence to this theory is the observance of cosmic background radiation that seems to play well into the predicted timeline of events. Was the Big Bang a huge gamma ray burst? Was the Big Bang the result of a huge white hole that came from the end of a huge black hole? hole. I guess this is where science meets fiction, or at least fantastical prediction. Some scientist theorists, including the late great Professor Stephen Hawking, predicted that black holes are folds in time and space that create portals to another universe. Perhaps white holes are just the outward end of black holes, playing into the multiverse theory, or perhaps they are the recycled matter that creates a whole new universe of itself. I guess it's all pretty mind-boggling and fantastical. Unfortunately, despite speculation regarding gamma ray bursts, we have never affirmatively observed a white hole, or even know enough about black holes to confirm or deny the existence of them. I wouldn't give up hope, though. Einstein predicted black holes, but his theory wasn't proven for a very long time. Just because we can't prove white holes exist right now doesn't mean that we won't. The first law of thermodynamics says that energy cannot be created or destroyed, so while we know that black holes seem to suck in energy, if we know what we know to be true, then we know that that energy isn't gone. When we find out what happens to it, we may well have our next big clue as to the existence of white holes and beyond. So that is our answer there for you. What do you guys think? Do you think there are white holes out there in the universe? Let me know in the comments section down below. Also, do let me know if you are scared of space. Would you go? Honestly, I do find it quite terrifying, but I really, really would. Thank you guys for joining in this episode of Life's Biggest Questions. Do make sure you leave a thumbs up on this video and share it with a space-loving friend. For now, I'm your host Rebecca Felgate. I'll catch you in the next video, but until then, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.